I don't know.
246, I want to say. Breathe on the microphone some more. Professional.
Real professional would know what episode we're on.
It's episode 246 of STC Pod, your start to continue podcast. Found every Friday, wherever you can find podcasts.
Even when I'm not here, it's still somehow magically is able to manifest itself.
Yeah, isn't that so?
And provide a positive and enjoyable listening experience for one more week.
Well, it provided an experience. I don't know how much enjoyable listening to it was. I had a bit of technical issues.
This from the guy who chirps about being in. About being an audio guy.
Oh, I chirp about being an audio guy.
Yeah.
Okay, so get into it. Last episode was a fantastic episode. I brought in Josh Creepleet for a full, geez, almost 90-minute chat because that guy turned out to become the most interesting man on the internet. Varied background, starting from gangland Jane and Finch to some mud hut in Africa. We went through it all and discovered this crazy lifestyle he's been going through. Unfortunately, my mic was blown out, overmodulated. It was so maddening when I first listened to the playback and discovered that. We were experimenting with new technologies in recording since Google Hangouts, our primary recording app, has closed down for no reason whatsoever, just because Google does that.
Oh, I consider that a blessing in disguise. That thing was nothing but a headache. And you know what? They don't deserve us, to be honest with you. We are now proud to be sponsored by Skype, our new recording platform. Skype, the new sponsor of STC Pod.
I guess. I don't know. Oh. It doesn't feel right. Doesn't.
Why? Because it's actually going to work?
Maybe.
Because there's no headache?
So, we were trying out a new service called Zencaster, I think it was called. And it seemed on paper to be perfect. It records separate tracks for both people, and at the end of the record it sends you those tracks, or you can download them, or something happens and away you go. But there, unless I missed it, there was no way to adjust your microphone pre-record, and like Josh could hear me fine, I could hear him fine, everything sounded beautiful. So we just went ahead with it, and no fault of Josh. And this guy was a true gentleman. He even before we started was like, "Hey, do you want to do a test record?" And I'm like, "Nope, let's go." 'Cause you got a guest there. You don't want to take more time from him than you have to. So
you're taking a page right out of my book.
I'm like, what could go wrong? It looks so easy and well put together, and everyone uses it. We know a lot of people that use it. So
wait, we know two people that use it.
That's a lot of people. So away we went, and apparently my track was way too hot.
Wow.
That'll happen, considering.
To quote Michael Scott, that's what she said.
So in post-production, which Joe was supposed to do, but he still was too busy to do that, I had to...
where was I?
I normalized the shit out of it. Hold I brought on. The volume down. I did everything I could.
Where was I? You can't be throwing blame on me. I know you like to back that truck up on me, but...
Yeah.
Where was I?
You were back by then, I'm sure.
No, I wasn't. No, I came back on the Friday.
I don't think so. Thursday.
No. Came back on the Friday.
You were at your posh glamping excursion. $2,000. Did you go on a cruise to Alaska? No, I went camping in Northern Ontario. Oh, That adds up. How many attendants do they give you at the campground for that kind of money?
Well, it's like when you go to like Dominican or something for like the golf resorts, they assign you a personal caddy. So yeah. you get one person. You get one Algonquinite to follow you around for the week. It was good. It was fun. Kids were up there for 17 days, so they had a good time.
17 days.
Off you go.
Holy Jesus.
See you later, bitches. Daddy's on vacation.
No wonder it's $2,000. Holy shit. Wow. Can you imagine? They had to endure like tent life for 3 weeks straight. They must have thought they went to a concentration camp or something. They're like, are we refugees, Daddy?
They're only in the tents when it's either raining. Not even that, because they were under the food tent for that part. They're only in the tents when they're sleeping, dude. And they're five and they're seven, so it's all fun.
So comfortable. Like you,
it's all shits and giggles.
For 3 weeks, your ass only knows a fold-out chair, a folding chair, or a picnic table. Joy.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm sure they'll never want to go camping again.
This isn't the first time they've gone camping, man. What are you talking about? They had a great time. Their 12-year-old cousin was up. They had their bikes up there.
Oh, the 12-year-old got banished too, to the north?
Yep.
You go up and protect the wall.
Winter is coming. Summer is almost over. Good, man. Good weather. And then, of course, my wife and I went up for Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, 7 days. And the first night was freezing cold. And I sleep in a sleeping bag with just my underwear. Because usually I got a good bag, right? It's a skinny one, but it's one of those thermosolate ones or whatever you call it.
Yeah, I don't like that.
And, dude, I was frozen.
I got to have my legs spread. I need leg room.
No, this isn't like a cocoon bag.
That's what you said, like skinny.
Yeah, as in not super thick.
That makes complete sense.
Yeah, it's a new technology. It's not like the old sleeping bags that are like 2 inches thick.
But I thought you had a queen size mattress or a king size mattress. Why aren't you just making a bed?
No.
Why sleeping bags?
The mattresses are the air mattresses you sleep on, but I was in the trailer.
Exactly. So you have a bed. You can make a bed.
Yeah. And then you still have to put your sleeping bag on top of it. I'm not making a bed and on in a trailer, dude.
What? Why wouldn't you?
Because it's a pain in the ass.
Oh, yeah. You make it once. You bring sheets and a comforter and you have a bed in there.
Dude, you hop in your sleeping bag. You're golden. Anyway, that first night was freaking cold. And the other nights gradually got... Of course, the time that we weren't up there was like a heat wave at nighttime. But I actually preferred to be cold, but this was just a little too cold. And then the other nights got really good, but... That was it. Brought my Kindle up. The book club started Robert Jordan Wheel of Time series. So I'm about 3/4 of the way through that. And I plowed through some more Persona 4 Golden on the Vita. So I'm 70-something hours into that right now. That was it, man. Just no treats. No treats around the campfire for Joey. First time I've ever done that.
Right.
It was a bad time to go on the stupid no sugar diet or whatever it is.
You didn't have chips.
No chips, nothing. It was frustrating.
You didn't have peanuts.
Nope.
Or your stupid sunflower seeds.
Didn't even have sunflower seeds. I could have, because that's perfectly fine, but I didn't have anything. I just had relegated myself to 3 or 4 beers a day, and that was it. So all I drank was beer and coffee while I was up there. Coffee for breakfast, and then sipped on beers throughout the day. Didn't see any bears, so that was good. That's it, dude. Did a couple trails.
Yeah, what do you do all day?
I either sit around and read.
And no one believes that.
Play some games.
I'm sure you sit down to read, but reading does not get accomplished. I'm sure when you wake up.
No, there's only one. There's only one day where I had a nap, and that was because I had a crappy sleep.
There is no way anyone believes that you're able to read more than a few pages without the sun suddenly appearing in a different area of the sky. Right?
No, it's a true story.
I don't think so.
And then, some days I hopped in the car and went off and did some trails on the highway.
What is that? Did trails on the highway? What's that?
There's the main. Have you never been to Algonquin?
No.
Really?
No.
There's the main. There's Highway 60, which runs through the park east and west. The main highway.
That's right. I've seen that.
And then off of that highway, on the north and south of it, there's the hiking trails you can do, and then all the different campgrounds you can camp at, spread throughout the park. So depending where you, which campground you go into, if you want to go do a certain trail, then you either have to go east or west on the highway, and then pull off in the parking lot at a certain point, and then start doing the trail.
Walking the trail.
Hiking the trail, depending on which length of trail you decide to go on. So they got some that are like 3 hours, and then they got some that are like an hour. Just depends how fast you hike it or whatever, or how difficult the trail is too.
Is there like trails where you can, bomb with your Jeep through there?
No, they're just walking trails. Some of them are so hard you can't even like bring bikes on them.
It's got to be like 4x4 trails there somewhere.
No, it's not allowed. It's a national park, dude. Provincial park.
Well,
respect nature.
All you rich guys in your Land Rovers, I'm sure you're bombing all through it. You don't care.
You know what? My parents did go to Picton one day, though.
How is that near Algonquin Park?
Well, they weren't with me. I'm just saying.
Oh.
They took one day of vacation and went to Picton for some reason.
One day.
Yeah.
What'd they do?
Well, I think they stayed overnight somewhere. I don't know. They did some bullshit. I wasn't even listening. Like, couldn't have been interesting, but get them out of the house. I think they did some winery there or something. They got wineries in and pick them.
Oh, yeah. They got lots.
I know our cousin Chuck hit up a winery somewhere out in the county.
That's right. Yeah. I gave him some sites to see.
Yeah. Next time you give them to me, and then I'll pass them on to him. Told you, worlds don't collide.
Well, it worked better with me just talking to him.
Well, that made one of us uncomfortable, so. Hey, I guess what I was watching tonight before you angrily texted me and wondering where I was for the record.
Were you watching mind pictures?
I was watching Captain Marvel.
Oh, how? That's not on, is it?
No. I just found it somewhere.
You found it somewhere. You don't even know how to find stuff. So
someone had it up on YouTube or something like that. Dude, that movie's horrible.
Oh, my
God. Like, the only thing saving it is I know how hot she is. Even though she lost a boatload of weight and got like rail thin for this movie, which I didn't really like. But, I don't even know if I should be watching this because I haven't seen any of the prior Marvel movies leading up to it.
Yeah, I don't think it matters. I think the post-credit thing might be a spoiler for you.
Skip that, right? Okay.
I think it's pretty standalone-ish.
Yeah, I'm really not enjoying it. It's there's too much goofiness in it.
Yeah, this from a Fast and Furious guy.
No, that's expected goofiness. That's fun.
No, the first six of those movies, they this were trying to be serious.
No, they weren't.
Yes, they were.
The first two, they were trying to be serious. And maybe number five, whatever one was in Brazil. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know why Marvel takes this comedic route for some of their movies. I just like my stuff serious, man.
Well,
serious and violent.
I've seen a bunch of good things that I can recommend to you.
No, I'm good. Thanks.
Obviously, you're not if you're watching stuff that you don't like.
Well, I'm giving it a try.
Okay. First of all, you know, if we're talking about feature films, I'm going to lay it on you to go check out Alita, the Battle Angel.
Oh, no interest.
Whatever it's called.
No interest. Eyes. I don't recognize that name. She's got big goofy eyes. I like her.
It was fantastic. And it has everything you'd be interested in.
You don't know what I'm interested in. What am I interested in?
Fantasy bullshit and yeah, the big anime eyes and
and all this stuff I know you're not interested in.
Oh, it was fantastic.
Oh my God.
I really loved it. Really did.
Where did you watch that?
Thought it was great. Thought the pacing was great. I liked the performances. Had what's his face in it.
Just save the review for another Fandango.
Yeah, this is what people actually want to hear, our thoughts on things, and not just Tom Cruise's. Right? So, I didn't know anything about this movie going into it. And maybe that's how I should leave it for the listeners, because it was a really fun way to discover the movie. Like, to be along for the ride without knowing what the hell's going on or where it came from. I had zero idea the origin of anything in this movie. The people, the, you know, where it's set, the world, the timeline. Didn't know anything. Just started watching it, and it was great. So check that out, Alita. And the other thing that I think is right up Joe's alley, because it's superhero stuff, but it is quite dark and ultra-violent and erroneous on the effects, is The Boys on Amazon Prime. I started that. It's a great conversation. Again.
Let's just pour your drink. Sorry, dude.
Is that necessary?
I'd heard about The Boys. Because that stupid promo keeps popping up on my Twitter feed.
Yeah. I
blocked it.
So the premise is, again, you got these superheroes, and they're integrated into, like, it's just common knowledge that you got these superheroes running around. And in fact, they've like organized themselves into a corporation. And so, you know, on the surface, they come off like a superhero, like they're everyone's hero, they're who you look up to. And I drew comparisons to how professional sports athletes are brought up. That's what this whole thing reminded me of. How superheroes are treated in this show is like how professional sports athletes are treated in our real world. And in fact, some of the same things happen, like the superheroes get traded to other cities and shit for contracts. So they're traded like professional sports people are traded. However, so when you peel back some of this organization, maybe these superheroes aren't as perfect as they appear. And we follow a storyline of these people who are trying to get in there and peel back those layers to find out what's really going on. And to maybe make these superheroes, you know, pay up some debts. So I'm only 4 episodes in, but I'm really liking it so far. It's nice and dark and edgy, and it's got comedy in it. And it's starring our boy from Banshee. You know, the dude from Banshee?
Well, there's 2 dudes. Oh, no, sorry. I'm not thinking of. Oh, I was wondering what happened to that guy. Is that the only thing he's done since Banshee?
Maybe. So it's got him, and it's got the guy who played Dread.
Hey, Siri.
Or like the guy who played Bones in the Star Trek.
Who's the star of movies? The Banshee?
Who's the Banshee?
One? I found 2. Banshee and Banshee Chapter. Which one? Yeah. Banshee features Ivana Milicevic, Anthony Starr, and Rick Thompson and others.
That's right, Anthony Starr.
Anthony Starr, yeah.
Anthony. It's Anthony. Not Anthony.
Anthony!
So what else has he done then? Going down that rabbit hole again. Anthony, New Zealand actor. There it is. So The Boys. The Boys is only in season 1?
Yeah.
Superheroes are often as popular as celebrities, as influential as politicians, and sometimes even as revered as gods, but that's when they're using their powers for good. What happens when the heroes go rogue and start abusing their powers?
I already summarized it for people. I think, if you'd have listened.
When it's the powerless against the super powerful.
Holy mackerel. But when I say edgy, let me tell you.
Are there tatas in there?
No, not enough, unless I haven't seen him yet. But there is one death that occurs between a man and a woman, and she accidentally
cuts off his pee-pee,
expires him.
Can you just talk normal?
No, I don't want to give it away. I don't want to give it away. It's not, you wouldn't imagine that happening. You don't know, is that what? What is going on right now? And then sploosh.
Hey, whatever happened to that Watchmen TV series?
Hey, I just saw a trailer for it this week on HBO, and looks good. Again, that'll be...
IMDb gave it 5.9 out of 10.
Ooh, yikes. I don't know. The trailer looked interesting. I didn't really understand anything that was going on, but...
Created and developed by Damon Lindeloft for HBO... What did he do again?
He did Lost, and he also did the show we just, you know, we watched, which was, you know, that one. What's it called? Where half the people disappear.
And then they come back?
No, no one came back. That was Avengers. Spoilers. What the hell was that called?
I haven't seen the fucking movie, dude.
What? Well... Oh, let's not talk about a 6-month-old movie.
Yeah, let's not.
What the hell was that show called? The Outsiders? The Out...
What, the one with the guy who was dating Jennifer Aniston?
Yes.
Or was married to her?
Yeah. I don't think they're together anymore.
Hey, Siri. Who was married to Jennifer Aniston?
I don't think they
Jennifer
were married.
Aniston was married to Justin Theroux from 2015 to 2018.
Oh, they were.
Yeah. So Justin Theroux. These kind of these British talk. Justin Theroux. What did we say? Justin Theroux.
The
Leftovers.
Leftovers. Yeah, I was almost there.
2014 to 2017. That was good. I never ended up watching the ending of it, though.
Yeah, you didn't watch the ending. Well,
that was a depressing show, but it was still excellent.
That's the dossier on Lindelof, is that he can't finish.
No, I just mean I never watched the ending of it.
Well, I'm saying that's what they say about him, this showrunner, too.
Listen, can't Lost finish. Was excellent.
Oh, yeah.
I've never seen the ending of it. I know again, it's excellent.
Yeah, again.
I don't want to know about it.
You never made it to the end.
Yeah, I never got around to watching the last season or two.
Well, what they
I'm sure it's about excellent.
Them makes sense.
No. I haven't heard anything. It's excellent.
It wasn't excellent. It was shit. It was exactly what we feared it would be.
Don't ruin it.
And he created
this, around to watching it.
This huge and vast world with many, many roads leading out, which they just didn't bother to explain 90% of.
What's his name again? Damon Lindeloft?
He's a JJ guy.
I'm okay with it. I'm on almost done season 4 of The Office, plowing through that. These are all seasons I've seen, though, so I know what happens.
It's good. It's good. Okay. We know Toby about
just,
The Office.
Toby just left The Office to go to South America, and his new blonde replacement has arrived.
Mm-hmm. We all know.
Yeah.
What? So, also, something else I've been watching.
Do you do anything other than watch TV?
Oh, by the way, I did finish Man in the High Castle, that last season. I did.
Hey, Bill, that. Did you ever finish that show about those Nazis?
Yeah, Man in the High Castle.
Yeah, that's the one.
Yeah, I finished the latest season. It was fine.
Oh, what would you think? It was just fine.
There was a couple shocking moments in that season. I don't really remember much about it, to be honest with you.
If I could be honest,
however, on Netflix, the next thing I'm watching, I'm trying to remember what it is now because you got me all flustered.
I called you out on your phoniness.
Well, there's new Comedians in Cars Getting Coffee, so I've watched the Eddie Murphy episode and I've watched the Seth Rogen episode. Those were good. I feel bad for Seth Rogen, though. Like, Eddie Murphy gets this out of the world Porsche like you've never seen before in your life. And then Seth Rogen got this piece of crap Blues Brothers police cruiser, you know, retired police cruiser from like 82.
Yeah, and he was probably loving it.
All beat to shit. And then Ricky Gervais comes on and he gets this Rolls Royce, which is like, again, out of this world. And poor Seth Rogen gets his beat
up. I saw this. I don't know what it was. It was probably a Rolls Royce or some version. There's this convertible. Looked like a Phantom or something the other day driving on the road. And it was this.
In your neighborhood?
Close to my neighborhood.
Yeah.
And it was this old guy and his wife in it, and he had on those little beret caps, whatever they're called. You know, the old man caps. Where the top of it sort of clips to the lid.
Yeah. You
know, the old man hats.
All the hipsters wear those now.
So this guy had that on, and this car was pimp. Like, it was drop-dead gorgeous, whatever it was. Some type of Rolls or Phantom convertible, and they were just driving down the street, and I thought this guy was, and he had to easily been like in his late 60s, early 70s, just driving like a pimp. And I thought, that's the coolest thing, man. And then today I saw some shithead driving around in a Lamborghini revving it up too high.
Well, speaking of Carl Urban, who we were just talking about.
I like Carl Urban.
What did I say he was in?
I wasn't listening, but I liked most of the stuff that he was in. He's a good-looking guy. I like what stuff he's been in. I know he was in Kevin's favorite movie, Judge Dredd.
Yeah, what was I talking about when I brought him up in Judge Dredd?
You didn't bring up Judge Dredd.
I didn't.
No, I just made. I just brought that up because I wasn't listening to what you were saying.
Brilliant conversation.
Derek, can you pull that back and play back what Bill said, please? Thanks.
Speaking of Carl Urban, who was married to Katie Sackhoff. You know who that is?
She's ugly, man. She's the blonde chick from Battlestar Galactica.
That's right. With
the potty mouth. Did I'm not watching. Like her at all. She's like that.
She plays Starbuck.
Like she's like the blonde chick from Third Planet from the Sun. The manly one.
She was great in Starbuck, though, in Battlestar Galactica.
Yeah, but she was just very manly.
Well, she was tough. She was a tough broad. That's what she's playing. Yeah. And I'm watching her in her latest show where she's playing another tough broad. It's called Another Life. That's on Netflix. You've probably seen that pop up on your page quite a bit because they've been pushing it.
Block that one.
And why? Is that getting not interested as well for no reason? Is it?
Yeah, I've got no interest in seeing that.
Why? There's not enough words in the title? Like, I don't understand how just me saying Another Life, you're instantly.
I don't, because I don't care about Katie Sackhoff. I don't care about her. I don't like her. I don't want to see her again. I had to put up with her through how many seasons of Battlestar?
Did you make it to the end?
Yeah, that was an excellent series. I owned it on DVD.
Of course, saw it in the theater.
So Katie Sackhoff can sack off.
Anyways, her new show is on Netflix, and it's pretty good. It's about, it's like a sci-fi kind of thing. Starts off Earth. And for some reason, this UFO type object just lands in the middle of nowhere and creates this huge kind of crystallized beacon. And they can't figure out what it is. It doesn't communicate with them. It doesn't move. It doesn't do anything. It's just there. And so they've figured out where it came from. So they send up a crew in a spaceship to go discover where it came from to see if it's a dangerous thing or not. If these aliens are here to conquer or are they here for peace? The thing isn't communicating to anyone, so they're going to go look for where it came from and try to make first contact that way. And of course, all kinds of drama and action ensue in that travel. It's pretty good. I'm about not too far, maybe 4 or 5 episodes in. Lots of drama.
So you get all this TV watching in between going to the gym and doing chores and doing stuff outside the house, right?
Mm-hmm. Well, that I watch in bed. I watch Netflix in bed before I go to sleep. So I get about 20 minutes at a time. It makes me tired, and then I go to sleep.
That's no way to watch a show in 20 minute pieces.
It actually is. For these binge type shows, because they pack their action into little segments divided by big pieces. So
you need to break up your action because you can't handle it.
Yeah. So I have a nice big action piece and then there's a denouement and I stop it there, even though it's like the middle of the episode. Then when you start it up again, there's like a little intro and then another big action piece and then the end of the episode.
Dude, come on, man.
That's how you watch these new shows. It's not my fault they segment these shows this way. It's because they're based on
binge watching. It is your fault.
They're based on binge watching.
Don't binge watch them.
I'm not.
I don't approve of binge watching.
I'm doing the opposite of binge watching. The
freaking goofballs of binge watch.
You can perfectly watch these shows in half an hour, 20 minute segments.
Because there's no enjoyment in binge watching. I hate it.
That's how they're built. They're built into a... to get you excited binge watch it,
like I said, the only reason I'm binge watching this stupid Office is because I've seen more than half of it already, so I'm trying to plow through it and get up to where I should be.
And they give you a nice piece of action at the end, so just split it up and you get two little action stories. And
when you binge watch, you're just rushing through it to get on to the next thing. You're not sitting and enjoying it and then contemplating on what just happened in that hour-long episode.
But I'm
before you go the office, into the next which hour. Which
is fine for me to be binging.
I just told That's you why fine. I'm binge-watching it, because I've seen all this stuff already, and I still remember what happened. You're watching something new. You want to take time to digest it, not just immediately go into the next hour-long episode and completely brain fart what just happened. I've always said it. There's nothing special. Binge watching makes a show less special than it should be.
Okay. You are physically unable to binge watch anything. So let's just get that out there. First off, maybe that's why you're so angry about it. You're jealous at people that can go more than 70% of an episode at once. So The Boys, that's on Amazon. So I'm watching, I've watched that at work. I've watched that at home on the TV. It's good times. But yeah, for some reason, Netflix I only watch in bed. And there's a ton more stuff to watch on Netflix. Holy mackerel.
How about you get outside and do something?
Well, today I went and got a haircut.
I cannot tell, but anyway.
Some groceries.
How much do you waste on a haircut? You can't chop it off yourself.
Oh, it's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. It was like 30-something. At
I'm so glad I don't have to
bother with that anymore. Foxy's Gentleman's Empire. It's called Foxy's Gentleman's something.
That sounds extremely dirty.
Yeah, and they're not really Foxy's in there, so... And it's always the roulette of, am I going to get that woman that, you know, butchers the back of my head every time? And it came down to the wire again today.
When I was a kid, and my dad used to take me to the Italian barbershop.
It had to be an Italian barbershop?
Well, the owner was Italian, so it was Italian barbershop. Anyway, they had three haircutters in there. Two men and one woman. There was Italo, the owner and haircutter. And then Richard was the other gentleman. And then I forget the lady's name, but I always used to hate it when, because you would be like, you could wait for your person or you could just sit there and hope that whoever finishes first is the guy that you want when it comes to your turn, right? Mm-hmm. So I always used to pass on her, and then I used to feel bad because no one wanted to get their hair cut by her because she was not the best, and her English wasn't very well.
Now, I remember the same thing as a kid. The hair cutting place, I don't know if it was Italian or not. I didn't ask for their ethnicities going in. Three people. I remember their names. The one guy had like long hair. That was Lou.
That was Richard for me. He was bald on top, but he still had the ponytail going on.
And then the other guy was Graham. And then
sounds very white.
And the third guy, I don't remember, because he was like the lowest of in seniority kind of thing. And I like getting Lou, but I never had the guts to not take whoever was next available. So I go, nope, waiting for Lou. Thanks. Couldn't do that. Too nice a guy as usual.
I used to hate that. That was because we used to always go like Saturday morning, right? And depending on how busy it was that day, you could blow your entire week, your Saturday morning, sitting and waiting to get your hair cut at this freaking place. Joys of being a kid and not being able to do what you want. I was going to say something else. Oh, I found my first gray pube today. Speaking of hair, that's what it was.
I'm sure it's not the first.
Dude, it was the first. And what? Well, because normally it's like, you know, shaved and tidied up down there. But I've been lacking in that area because I've been so busy doing other stuff. But I looked down today in the shower. And what the hell? What? No, I was drying myself off. And I looked down. I go, what is this? So I immediately ripped it out and then burnt it with a lighter. Just to teach it a lesson.
Yeah. Where was this? On the top or down below?
In the middle.
In the middle? On the shaft?
No.
Do you got them growing up the shaft now at your age?
Dude, in the middle.
Yeah, that's
the but shaft. What do you mean the shaft, dude?
Well, I ask you, do you have it growing up the shaft now?
No.
No?
Am I supposed to?
I don't know.
Anyway, it was above the shaft, so in the middle.
That's upper. So it was in the fro.
All right, okay, so like the top fro.
Yeah.
Which normally isn't there, which is probably why I've never seen it. But there's only one. I checked. I combed through it all. That was like seriously upsetting.
What would you have done if that was down below in the ball area?
I still pulled it out still, and I burned the crap out of it, teach it a lesson, and performed an exorcism on it.
You're a wacko.
What? You going to keep your great pubes?
Don't got none.
Yeah, okay.
Don't.
Dude, I inspected your body at TMG. There's some gray popping up all over.
Nope. Yeah, on my face. Nothing.
You can't see everywhere I can see. The way you were walking around that room like it was your house.
Oh, as if.
Holy crap. Good thing I'm a man and I don't care. Prancing around.
Yeah, okay. There's no way I would do that with you in the room.
Really? Why?
Because Mr. Grabass? I don't think so.
Grabass.
Yeah.
I'm not grabbing your ass.
You've tried many times.
I'll slap it when you're in jeans and shit. Yeah. That's what real men do.
So, yeah, have you heard... did you get to hear last week's episode?
It was excellent.
Yeah. How rude is that, man? You got someone
I said it was excellent.
Yeah, Josh on there. You don't want to hear his story.
I haven't listened to a podcast since I left for camping. I listened to the ones that I listened to on the way up. And then I ran out. Because I was all caught up to date. And then when I got back home, I can't find where I put my iPod.
You can play them from your phone.
I don't play podcasts off my phone. It drains the battery.
It's a brand new phone. I thought it was
good. You got to conserve the battery. I'm not going to run into battery issues early.
Yeah, that's really going to wear it down.
So that's why I always listen to it in my iPod because I can... that's what I... Because I got the Nano, so it clips to your belt, and you don't even feel it.
Well, I just want to say a big thank you to Josh for coming out for that, and it was an excellent episode. I hope everyone can work past my bad audio. Josh's audio was perfect, so I definitely want to throw that out there that if you've missed it, go back and check out that episode. He had a lot of good stories.
Great job.
And if you wanted to hear more from me, I hope you all went and listened to the one episode of Retro Fandango I told you to listen to, which was the one on Mel Brooks that I was a guest on. We talked about Mel Brooks movies. So that was a fun episode too.
Do you hear the crowd rushing?
Yeah, I do.
The foot stomping to get to the Mel Brooks?
Yeah, just because you don't understand it.
Dude, I've seen his movies.
You would be like a character in a Mel Brooks movie.
I don't need to gush about these movies.
We wouldn't even need to rewrite the part at all. Put Joe in a Mel Brooks movie and he would fit right in.
Yeah. Live in the now, dude. Live in the now.
Live in the now. Okay. Also, I want to send people over to a new YouTube channel that I started up with the little kid. For those of you who liked seeing the little kid pop up in my videos on the Start to Continue YouTube channel, thought, what the hell? Let's give the kid her own channel. And we started that up, put one video out there because we don't want Joe to get upset. The kids are appearing on the Start to Continue channel, even though he doesn't appear there anymore. So if you want to check that out, go look at, you know, the last video that was on Start to Continue, my pickup video, and it gets linked from there. Or just look for, it's called Addy Adventures on YouTube. And the first episode was called Snake Alley. So go check that out. I'm sure Joe's watched that, giving me lots of support.
That was an excellent episode about the board game, yes.
Right? About a board game?
You said Snakes and Ladders, right?
No, I said Snake Alley. Mm-hmm.
No, I'm behind on my YouTube videos, too. Sorry.
Really? Because you're not behind putting out YouTube videos.
I put out one. Sorry. Doesn't mean I'm watching them.
Yeah. You put out one. Not on Start to Continue. I told you to come in and we'd do that pickup video together, and he refused.
I'm at home.
Yeah.
Five minutes away. And you wanted me to drive 30 minutes to help you shoot your video.
Well, you could have had stuff in there.
I didn't have stuff. So... did you end up shooting it?
You don't even know it got published?
What did I just say 2 minutes ago? I'm not up to date on YouTube videos.
Wow. Really? What were you busy today doing? I know what you're busy today doing.
What did I do today? Well, I dropped the kids off at my mom's.
Right. Because my... looking after them.
One of my nephews goes over on Tuesdays. So they wanted to see him.
Yeah, oh yeah. First day back from camping. How do I get rid of these kids?
So they, I dropped them off, and then I went out for a couple hours and did some thrifting.
Your life is exactly like soap operas.
And then I went back there and had lunch, and then I brought the kids home and I washed the car.
You know how in the soap operas, they all have kids, but you rarely see the kids. And if you do, they're there for a second, and then they have the housemaid take them. Take little Brock upstairs to go play with his Legos. What a life.
What did I do today? Oh, and then I watched the first half of Captain Marvel this afternoon because I was tired. So I just wanted to relax. Kids got their swimming lessons next week. Last round before school starts.
In your pool.
Yeah, we're going to try that this time. Going to go with the private lessons because he's not grasping two of the strokes that he has to do. So we're hoping that private lessons will he'll learn better or something.
Jesus Christ.
Can you get
me a job where you work? What? Do you embezzle on the side? Like, seriously, what is...
Dude, it's not that much more expensive.
He's not getting the 12th and 13th stroke correct, so... What? Why does he have to have every single... Is he going to be a lifeguard next year? What? I don't understand.
I'm just saying.
What? Can he swim? Yes. Does he have to swim.
Do every swims underwater. Single stroke?
No. Well, he's fine.
We want him to become proficient. He's got to become proficient enough.
No, he's got to be the best. He's got to be.
Anyway, in the end, it's cheaper if he passes.
It's cheaper if you just swim with him in the pool every day.
I don't even do that. I barely go in my pool.
Yeah, exactly. You two go in there, and the kid learns to swim by being in the pool every day.
We're hoping that with a private, he'll pass it because if we do, he failed his last one that we went at the rec center. So if we do this one again, we don't think he's going to pass again. So that's two wasted lessons.
Who gives a fuck?
It's money, dude.
You own a pool. He doesn't need. I'm saying, if you have your own pool, like for years, people just learned how to swim by going out to the lake or jumping in their own pool. You know?
No, I did. I never had a pool, so I had to do the swimming lessons every weekend. or every week, depending on which. Yeah, I hated that stuff.
I never took a swim lesson
all the way up to
my life.
Lifeguard training.
I never took a swim lesson, yet I know how to swim.
Yeah, I know how to swim I'm
not,
too.
I'm not competing in the Olympics. I'm not, you know, I'm not trying to earn a living doing it.
There's levels of competency, I guess, and confidence that you can instill into young swimmers that swimming lessons help with.
Well, I'm not going to say you're wrong. I'm just saying if you have your own pool and your kid's in it every day, they are going to become an amazing, proficient, and confident swimmer just by going in it.
Yeah, but anyone can just sort of...
They become fish.
Pull and swipe with their arms and pull themselves along or swim underwater. But
hey, Timmy, that is not a proper backstroke. You need to do a lateral adjustment to 25 degrees. That's this perfect world you live in. Perfect. Like I said, soap opera. Everything's got to be perfect. Everything's got to be perfect.
That's just in your head.
Yes, it's in your head.
I told you, man.
You need to calm down, man. Just let things go. Let them enjoy the pool. Your kids are going to be the opposite, where they don't even want to go in the pool because it's work every single time. It's a freaking lesson. It's true. Make the pool fun. Throw the kid in the pool. I'm jumping in with you. Every day, kids become fish that way. Nope.
Hope you're happy.
I get my private tutelage from Swimtown America coming. Ay, 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 ay.
Sorry I said anything.
Oh, that's good, man. I'm proud of you.
I'm just trying not to waste money on continually going to lessons and not passing.
You're missing my point.
I get your point, but I want them to become confident and competent at the same time.
Totally miss my point. I submit that they'll become more confident by just being in it on their own. That's how kids grew up, man. 30 years ago. There's no private swim lessons outside of the estates, you know?
There was. You just probably didn't hear about them. I didn't know about them. My parents wouldn't have done that, even if we had a pool. Ship me off to the rec center.
Well, I'm glad for you, man. You're keeping the economy going.
Yeah, great.
I appreciate what you're doing for our economy.
I try to waste money. Thank you very much. All right. I'm going to wrap this one up. I don't think I have anything else. So you got a new pickup video? Everyone go to STCPod. No, youtube.com/starttocontinue and check out Bill's latest pickup video. And I've got part 3 of my Transformer collection video up on My Life in Collecting on YouTube.
Yeah, watch out because Bill's getting comfortable in front of the camera. I don't know what that means.
Maybe he'll get naked.
Watch out. Starting to get comfortable. So the stories are coming out now on camera.
I don't know what that means.
You haven't seen the video. I'm actually given time to tell a story during a video.
That's good.
Not moving along. No one cares. By the way, I can give an update on that video if you saw it. You saw in the video a Super Nintendo that got thrown in on a deal because I thought it was trashed, and Haji left a comment, said it was like, you know, where you plug in the power to the Super Nintendo, that pillar that's on the inside, yeah. that gets snapped off, right? This one is half snapped off, so I thought it was shit, and Haji was just like, no, plug it in, that'll work, and sure enough, I plugged it in and it works, and that sucker cleaned up really nice, super nice. So that worked out.
Wait a minute. Is it half? Is it about to snap off, though?
It's like half there. It's still there. It's sturdy. That still works, though. So, and this thing cleaned up really good. Now, those...
yeah, but it's about to break off.
Those one chips everyone was talking about recently. Was that just the super mini, or was that the main supers?
No, that's just the main one.
It is just the main one?
Yes. The one so chips.
Yeah, so you're looking for...
Well, you really have to open it up, though, and look at the board.
But it's a good indicator if it says UN3. Is that what it was?
Maybe. That's still not 100%, though. You have to open it up.
Well, if you can see the pillar there is half there.
Which one are you looking at? The one on the right or on the left?
Oh, it's the very end here.
Yeah, no, I can't. I just see a dark hole.
But, yeah, cleaned up nice, though, eh? I see a dark hole. Good truck.
I don't know. It looks good. Do I have it? I only got one. I only have one Super Nintendo. Can you believe that?
Holy shit. That pillar came off, and it's sitting in my plug now. Now it's just two wires sticking out.
So take it apart and see if you can fix it.
The thing's right there now, stuck in my plug.
All that. So it just needs to be it just needs to be soldered to it.
There's no soldering. It's plastic.
Well, you said two wires are sticking out.
Yeah, in here, they're not protected by the plastic pillar anymore. Anyways, that will be for sale with a really good price at the next Barry Game Exchange, which is happening this September.
Speaking to the mic. What? Hello? Keep going, dude.
Give the Game Exchange plug.
Oh, my God. Well, you were doing it.
I never remember the date. You got it in front of you.
Okay, Barry Game Exchange, Canada's largest and longest running video game and geek culture trade show. I like to think we have something to do with that. Sunday, September 15th, 11 a.m. to 4 p.m. at the Eastview Arena, 453 Grove Street East in Barrie. 140 plus tables of video games, accessories, board games, vintage toys, geek art, and so much more. 11 a.m. is the early bird admission, which is $10. 12 to 4, regular admission, which is $5. Kids under 10 are free. And be sure to stop by. The Cartridge Club will have a presence there at a number of tables, correct?
Mm-hmm.
And you can check us out, STCPod. We'll have their own table. Actually, we will have... two tables.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. What's happening with you?
I was waiting for you to acknowledge. Like, oh, yeah, that's right.
That's right. You will find all the Cartridge Club people there. We got red tablecloths to signify the Cartridge Club presence there. But there'll be even more Cartridge Club vendors than tablecloths, because that's how big the community is.
And you can check me out in my new Cartridge Club black t-shirt. Very form-fitting.
Very form-fitting.
Very aerodynamic.
Extra small. Mm-hmm. And so that's a big Cartridge Club weekend. A lot of people coming in all over to experience it. I've decided the night before, the Saturday, you know what? I will do another Bilbecue. I wasn't going to. I didn't want the hassle of cooking, but I'm saying piss on it. I will barbecue that Saturday. Some burgers and some weenies, corn, of course, corn on the cab. And if you're lucky enough.
What appetizers are you guys here?
Chips? Is that?
It's not an appetizer, really.
I can only do so much. I'm already stressing about barbecuing.
Are drinks provided for?
BYOB will be the best thing for you.
Boo.
And if you know where I live, then you're probably invited. So that's how you get in the inner circle. Find out where I live. Joe's invited.
I am?
Yep.
That's awesome. I was invited last time. I was like, what? You got a barbecue?
Yeah, I don't think so, but you're invited.
Well, maybe I'll make an appearance.
Well, there will be some big-time Cartridge Club celebrities there for sure. And I just found today there's in Barrie, there's a barcade downtown. And I did a little scouting mission today and checked it out. It's not very big, but it's got about 5 or 6 different pinball machines and about 12 arcade machines, maybe, for a $5 admission. Play all you want. So that could be on the agenda too.
Is it like the Peelers where you gotta keep buying drinks?
Gee, I don't know, eh? For $5. I don't know what the deal is, but
the bar's like, get you in the door, you buy some drinks, and then you want to buy some food.
Yeah.
Buy some wings. So. All right, well, sounds good. I think it's, and on that note, I think we should wrap this episode up. This is our first record ever on Skype. Here's to it actually working.
Mm-hmm. And don't forget to go to cartridgeclub.org. We got the forums there. You can make comments on.
No, everybody's on Discord, man.
This episode or any other podcast you hear on the Cartridge Club. By the way, I'm sorry we didn't get to Lotus Corner this week.
That's two weeks. It's 2 weeks in a row.
Yes, but we do thank all the commenters out there. You got Frantic, Lotus, Discart's been commenting. Lots of guys. Lots and lots and lots of guys. Don't forget to check out last week's Josh Creep episode.
Post and post it. I don't know.
You're the one that has to end the recording.